Welcome to the office of the Westchester County Clerk's Westchester Records Online, or WRO, tutorial series. And welcome on behalf of Westchester County Clerk Tim Idoni. Today's WRO tutorial will demonstrate how to search for and view maps in Westchester Records Online, including looking up filed maps by name or map number, using the county block index to search for a map of a particular property, and what unofficial resource maps are available in WRO and how to access them. To begin, navigate to Westchester Records Online at wro.westchesterclerk.com. On the login screen, we will log in with our username and password to search as a registered user so we can see images of maps. If you haven't registered a user ID before, but would like to register to view images, click the link just above the login fields. You will then be led through a series of screens to set up a registered user account and be provided with subscription and payment options. We offer two subscription levels, a one-day subscription for $20, which ends at midnight of the following day, or a year-long subscription for $1,200, which ends 365 days from the current day. If you're already a registered user, but your subscription has expired, simply log in with your username and password and click the Renew link in the upper right corner. If you've forgotten your username or password, you can click on the appropriate link below the login fields. Once we've logged in, we'll click on the Maps tab. The Maps tab has two sub-tabs, one for filed maps and one for resource maps. We'll concentrate on the Filed Maps tab first, where official subdivision maps filed with this office are stored. The easiest way to find a map is to look it up by its map number. Often a recorded land record will include the map number of a related map. If you have the map number for the map you are seeking, or the volume and page for an older map, simply type the number in the map number field or the volume and page in the volume and page fields, and then hit enter or click search. When searching by map number, it's generally a good idea to make sure the exact match bubble is filled at the top. Otherwise, your results could contain maps that merely contain the intended number. For instance, if I wanted to view map 123 and searched for it by number, but with the partial match bubble filled, I will get many maps that simply contain 123. Once I check the exact match bubble, all my results are map 123. While I received multiple search results for map 123, all the results are referring to the same map, but it is listed for each county block and municipality included in the map. Clicking Details at the end of the line will provide us with additional information about the map, including its full title, map date, file date, surveyor, and architect, if known, as well as icons to view the image or images of the map. In the Details section, we can see that map 123 consists of 5 images. A map can have multiple images because the map had to be scanned in segments due to the technology available when it was scanned, or the map may be made up of multiple sheets. When we click on one of the map images, it will open up as a PDF in a new window. Viewing this particular image, we can see that the document was scanned in segments, as the technology at the time it was scanned couldn't capture and store the entire image as a single map. We can click on each of the images to see the entire map in individual segments. If you want to search another map number, you can enter it in the field at the bottom of the viewer window and click Show Document, and the new map will display in the open window without the need to go back to the full search screen. Sometimes a deed or other land record will reference a map by name and does not include a specific map number. You can use the other search fields to search for maps based on any of the other attributes of the map. If a land record names a map without providing the map number, you can enter part of the name of the map in the map name field and then click search. Make sure that the partial match bubble is filled in at the top of the search fields, since the name recited in the land record rarely matches the name of the map in WRO exactly. Looking at an example deed, it references a map called Map of building lots and villa sites belonging to Andrew Finley, Esquire, situated at Tuckahoe in the town of Eastchester, Westchester County, New York. If I put that entire title in the search field and try to do an exact search, it is highly unlikely that I'll get any results. Instead, it's generally better to enter a small portion of the title, and if a property owner is mentioned in the title, it's a good idea to include it in your search terms. I'm going to just enter the property owner's name, Finley, in the map title field, and then click search. Since I received multiple search results, and I know that the property I'm interested in is located in Eastchester, I can enter Eastchester as a municipality and click search again to narrow down my results. Now I've narrowed my results to only four maps, and I can click on each one to see if it's the map that I'm looking for. When I click on the first map, I can see that the title exactly matches the map title in the deed I was looking at, so I found the map that I was looking for. If you want to search for maps of a particular area without a specific map in mind, you can search by county block to see all maps that touch that block. Westchester County is divided into county blocks, which are different than the local section, block, and lot assigned by the individual municipalities for taxing purposes. If you enter a block number and click search, WRO will display all the maps that touch that particular block. Sometimes you may be looking at a map and want to see what other maps show the same area. You can look at the block numbers associated with the map you are looking at and enter one of the blocks and click search to view other maps of that area. To look up the block number for a specific area of the county or a specific property, you can find the county block index maps under the Resource Maps subtab. Once we click on the Resource Maps subtab, we'll choose County Block Index Maps from the Type of Resource Map dropdown. You then must choose which municipality the block is in and then click Search. An index map of the municipality you chose will open with lines and numbers indicating the sheets covering the municipality. You will see links to all the numbered sheets for the municipality listed in the frame to the right. Click the sheet number on the right that corresponds to the sheet containing the land or property you are researching. You can expand the viewer window and zoom in and out just like any other map to make it easier to find the block that you are looking for. We'll click on sheet 24 because we're interested in a property on Terrace Place in Tuckahoe. We'll zoom into the area where we know Terrace Place to be, and we can see that the area we are interested in is in block 2825 at the portion of Terrace Place that intersects with Main Street. You may notice on this map that Terrace Place doesn't appear to intersect with Main Street. You may also notice other oddities, like the portion of Sagamore Road that enters Tuckahoe is referred to as Dusenberry Avenue. The county blocks and the maps that display them were created in the 1930s, so you may notice that some roads and other features may have changed names or even locations. At the time these maps were created, Terrace Avenue did not intersect with Main Street in Tuckahoe, as it does today. Since we found that the property we are interested in is in block 2825, we can enter the block number in the field in the lower right of the viewer window and click Search Block. The viewer window will close, and the search results frame in the main WRO window will now display all filed maps that touch block 2825. If we stay on the Resource Maps subtab and click on the Type of Resource Map dropdown, we'll see that there are different sets of maps that this office has made available online which aren't official or filed maps. These are sets of maps that have come into possession of this office over the years, which visitors to our office have used as a resource to better understand the layout of properties and features of the land from earlier in the history of Westchester County. We have atlases of Westchester County from as far back as 1867, as well as atlases of Yonkers and Mount Vernon and Pelham dating back to the 1800s as well. There are also sets of maps of particular areas of interest, such as the 1836 proposed Croton Aqueduct and the Crestwood and Yonkers Park sections of Yonkers. Finally, we have Yonkers tax maps from about 1960. We expect to add historical assessment rolls and tax maps for all of the municipalities of the county to our collection of resource maps later in 2016 and 2017, contingent on receipt of state grant funding for the project. To view any of these historic resources, simply choose the resource you would like to view and click Search. If you would like to view the 1930 Atlas of Westchester County, you must also choose a municipality from the drop-down, as we did when searching the county block indexes. Upon opening any of the resource maps, an index to the collection will be displayed, with a listing of all the images in a frame to the right. Simply find the area you want to view in the index, and then click on one of the map pages in the frame on the right. Please be aware that the numbers of the images on the right do not always correspond exactly to the pages in the index. If you click on a page and it's not exactly where you intended to be, you can continue clicking on the images in the listing on the right until you find the page that you need. Also be aware that while the maps we display are typically a single page, the indexes often have multiple pages and title pages, so scroll down to see if there are additional pages that may be of help. If we are interested in seeing how the village of Portchester in the town of Rye was laid out earlier in its history, we could choose the 1867 Atlas from the drop-down and click Search. On the index page, we'll scroll down to Rye Town, and we can see that pages 11, 12, and 14 have maps of Rye Town. I'll click on page 11 in the frame to the right, and I can zoom in on the section showing Portchester. While I can see the broad layout of Portchester and where it is situated with respect to other communities, I was hoping to see more detail, so I'll click on page 12 to see if there's a better image of Portchester. While map 12 shows me much more detail, unfortunately it doesn't show Portchester, so I'll click on map 14 to see if I can find what I'm looking for in that map. And bingo! Map 14 shows me a wonderfully detailed view of Portchester toward the middle of the 19th century. As I zoom in near the Byram River, I can see the Abendroth Brothers Mill and Foundry, explaining why the road that was later built at that location is named Abendroth Avenue. As I move south, I can see that Westchester Avenue was called Purchase Avenue at that time, and as I scroll the map to the west, I see a large piece of property owned by Merritt, the namesake of the Merritt Parkway, just about a mile or two away. And as I scroll back out, I can see that in the middle of the 1800s, only the downtown area of Portchester was developed, and the residential areas that exist today were mostly large estates and farms. By looking at the various atlases, you can get a very good picture of the development of Westchester County over the past 150 years. Starting at the first atlas in 1867, the county was largely farmland, and by the last atlas in 1930, the county was largely developed and taking on the shape and character of Westchester County today. Thank you for joining us today for the WRO Map Searching Tutorial video. Please visit us online and check out our other tutorials at westchesterclerk.com and visit our YouTube channel and Facebook page and follow us on Twitter. Thank you.